So guys, welcome back to channel Get to Byte and continuing with our embedded C code and the application code for our W25QB flash memories. Okay, so the first thing that I have told you we are going to do is the read and we are going to read a register, write a register, read the GDC ID and read and write on the memory addresses of our flash memory. And I have also explained to you the block diagram of the memory block of the memory for these memory chips, like what is their block representation, what is their starting address and what is their ending address. So first thing that I am going to do is I am going to read the status register and correspondingly also going to write the status register data on the status register. So if you go to the section of our instructions and inside in the read status register and the write status register, so there you can see it is written that the instruction is entered by driving the CS pin low. That is by driving the chip select pin of a slave device low and then shifting the instruction 05H from SR for status register 1, 35H for a status register 2 and 15H for status register 3. And on the rising of the clock, the DO pin at the falling edge of the clock with most significant bit. Okay, so now the, as you can see, so like we get the... Okay, so now from the block diagram here, the waveform, you can see that we first need to send the instruction corresponding to the which status register we want to write. Okay, and then we will going to read our status register from in the next instruction cycle. So like when we send the 05H, it takes 8 bits. So the first 8 bits are occupied for sending the data from a master to the slave. So master out, slave in. So that's what we send in the DI pin. Okay, master out, slave in. Slave receives the instruction. And then in the next, from starting from the 8th bit, we are going to read the contents of the status register. So MOSI pin, master out, slave, master in, slave out. That slave data is sent by the slave. We'll be sending data from our master to our master. Okay, and the starting will be initiated by making the CS pin low, and when the CS pin will be taken high, then it will stop reading the status register. If we will not take out, if we will not make the CS pin high again after reading for next 8 bits after sending the instruction, then we are going to receive the next status register contents. Okay, so the function is also very much simple in the same way how. First, we have set the CE pin to low. I have defined its macro in my upper file. Okay, to make the SPI port and the SS pin low. And for high, I have correspondingly defined the macro for making my pin at high. Okay, so the instruction is very simple. Making the CS pin low, then sending the byte of according to the status register read. Now, SR read will be having the address of 0H, 35H or 15H. Same way out, reading the status register read byte, and in this function will return the contents which are received by my master and storing them in a variable and then returning from that function. Same way the read register, for write register, the instructions are 01, 31 and the 11H. So first making the CS pin low. And one thing important is that when we want to write on the status register, we first need to enable our flash. Like write enable is an instruction that we need to send, that we are going to write data on the contents of the memory address or on the contents of the SP of the status register. Okay, so the write enable is initiated, instruction is sent by sending the command 06H and making the pin high low. It's like a proper SPI pin, the signal. So making the CSPC pin first low, then sending the write enable instruction which is 06, and then making the CE pin again high. So as to tell that okay, my now write instruction has been completed, and I am going to send data instruction that you have to write on the memory or on the status register. Okay, so write status register first, write enable flash. Then making the CS pin low again, as it is mentioned here that first for sending the instruction of on what status register to write, we will first make the CV pin low, and then we are going to send the 8 bytes for the data that we need to write on the status register. Okay, so there's a simple read and write status register instruction that we need to that functions that we have write. Okay, so that's the read and write status register. Now if we move to our main function, and in the main function I have write in the while loop that we are just going to read the status register SR1, SR2, SR3 and with a delay of 100. Okay, so now we are going to see the first, this will send the instruction of my for reading it, and then it will read the contents of my status register, and we are going to see this on the logic analyzer. Okay, so let's just build the code and make our program run inside our microcontroller. Now inside the logic analyzer, if we start it, I have connected this to my channel 6420. So you can see here that first I have sending, as I have first reading the status register 1, so it's, remember, its instruction is 0x05. So first it has sent the 05 on the instruction, and then reading, and on the reading of this status register 1 context, it returns 00. Okay, and then it sends the 35, which is instruction code for my reading status register 2, and then reading its content, it is 0x02. Okay, and same way out for status register 3, sending the status 30, the command 15, 0x15, and then its content is read as 0x60. So as you can see in the logic analyzer also, that we are very efficiently able to read the contents of a status register. Same way out, you can write the status register contents according to the specification or the things which you want for your code. Okay, as I have told, as you can see from the previous videos of mine, that what things we need can configure from a status register. For now, by default, we are going to use the by default values of our status registers only, as we don't need to change any of those things. Okay, now then coming to the next instruction of our GDC ID and the unique ID. As you can see in the GDC ID, that let me just navigate to that part. Okay, as you can see from the JDC ID also here, that we just need to send the byte 1 will be our 9F. Okay, so I have declared one this macro of 0x9F on my the main.cc, as you can see here my JDC ID is 0x9F. Okay, and then just we need to read first send this, and then we just need to read these registers. Okay, so the read the 3 bytes from our continuously 3 bytes from our SPI procession. Okay, so first sending the 0x9F, and then first I will receive the manufacturing ID MF0 to MF7. So X will be having the value of EF, that is my manufacturing ID, and then the device ID, which is of 16 bytes, that will be 4018, and that will be stored on Y and Z. Okay, so here also the commands are very simple. Okay, we just need to send first this JDC ID, and then we are need to read these contents, we need to continuously read these 3 bytes. So first 0 to 7 bytes are our JDC ID instruction 0x9F, and then reading the from subsequently from 8 to 15, 15 to 23, 23 to 30. One, okay, we are going to read the contents continuously, read the 24 bytes. So now in our code, if you will see that in the main function, let me just uncomment this JDC ID again, okay, and let me just make this part comment, okay, so that you can see properly in the this logic analyzer. And let me just wait with the delay of something. Okay, build the code. And if I run this code inside my microcontroller, okay, and now opening the logic analyzer and again starting the session. So you can see that MOSI master out slave in. So master is sending the command of what? 0x9F. Okay, so master out slave in, and at that point our slave is not sending to us anything. Then we are sending the Then we are going to read the three continuously 3 bytes from our the flash memory so as to read the JDC ID. So that is what we have done. MISO has received EF, that is a manufacturing ID, 4018, that is a device ID, the first reading the 3 bytes, then again sending the 9F, and then again receiving those 3 bytes. Okay, so as to see this, you can also see them in the hexadecimal or in WOTSO format in the from the logic. This is like for the from the logic analyzer, just first showing you that how these functions are working and how things will work out. Okay,